Hey everyone, it's Colin. How's it going? These mini consoles can be a lot of fun, but for some gamers, they don't quite scratch that retro itch. A lot of people have taken to building their own using the Raspberry Pi, so this time we're going to take a look at an enclosure that does a bit more than just look the part. Okay, so these are a set of enclosures for the Raspberry Pi circuit board from a company called RetroFlag. They sent them my way to review, and to be honest, I think they're really cool. Obviously, they're plastic enclosures. You supply your own Raspberry Pi board and install them in the enclosure. Installation itself is actually really easy. It's just a few screws, a couple of cables, and they even include a screwdriver in the box. And there's some additional features and functionality on these enclosures that I think make them really stand out. First, of course, is the build quality and the design. These really look like mini versions of the original consoles. They did a great job on the plastic molds. The color is correct. The size is even accurate to like their Nintendo counterparts. You put the Super NES Raspberry Pi case up against a Super NES Classic, and I don't think a lot of people would even be able to tell the difference. The other thing that's really nice about these is some additional functionality that they provide. For example, because of some of those internal cable harnesses, it lets you reroute the ports. So you can have the power and HDMI ports on the back of the enclosure, but a pair of USB ports up front to plug your controllers into. Now, you don't lose access to the Ethernet or other pair of USB ports either, because they're hidden behind a little door on the side of the console. There's a 2-pin connection for a cooling fan, along with a spot in the top case for it to snap into, but one isn't included with the kit. You have to supply it yourself. That's a bit of a bummer. They have a working power switch and reset button, but there's one killer feature related to that power switch. Because the Raspberry Pi runs a full installation of Linux, if you suddenly pull the power on it, you run a very real risk of corrupting the data on your SD card. That power switch on these cases is hooked up through software to a script you install on the Raspberry Pi, so when you turn the switch off, the Raspberry Pi goes through a safe shutdown process. These cases are available in NES, Super NES, Super Famicom, and Genesis/Mega Drive versions, and there are also matching controllers that you can get as part of a combo deal or separately. The prices on these enclosures are also pretty reasonable as well. Enclosure alone is about $25, and a combo pack with a controller and the enclosure goes for about $35. So pretty fair pricing considering that additional functionality, if you ask me. Anyway, if you are thinking about building your own Raspberry Pi, like RetroPi kind of setup, and you're looking for an enclosure to put it in, I think these are really worth checking out. Big thank you, of course, goes to RetroFlag for sending these my way to check out. I will include a link down in the description if you're interested. If you like this one, I would appreciate a thumbs up. Be sure to subscribe if you haven't already. You can follow me on Twitter and Instagram @ThisDoesNotComp. And as always, thanks for watching.